Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. On video 40, we talked about running model in integer 8 bits, INT8 format. Now, I'd like to show you a real example of a typical full inference flow. Stage number one will be to get all the data we need, the models, the data sets, make sure the model optimizer is set up to work with Tensorflow, and so on. Stage number two will be what we call transfer learning. We will add new classes to the model and retrain the model to classify them. This is a very typical flow. If you need to classify specific objects, you do not need to build the deep learning model from scratch. You download a public one, add the classes you need, provide images for these classes, and just retrain the model to classify them. We will take a mobile net model and retrain it to classify new classes of flowers it was not originally trained for. You can follow the same procedures to add your specific classes. Stage number three, we will use the model to run classification and check that it is really working. Stage number four, we will calibrate the model to INT8. Stage number five, we will try to benchmark the performance and see if there is really benefit when we move from FP32 to INT8. Stage number one, first, define the install directory, initialize OpenVINO, go to the model optimizer installation, and make sure the prerequisite for TensorFlow are met. Now, let's get the model and the setup for this example from GitHub. And let's download the images for the new classes. You can see that under flowers, photos, I have five directories, each with the name of the new classes and holding images for this specific flower. Stage number two, I'm going to run TensorFlow to retrain the model for the new five classes. All the instructions are available to you in the transcript. You can just copy paste them. I'm retraining a mobile net model, but you can do it for other topologies as well. Now, I'm just renaming the labels file, and I have a new model. It's called retrainedgraph.pb. I'm going to generate IR files. I'm running the model optimizer with the right scale values for this model. I've explained in previous videos how to find these numbers, and I got the new IR files I can now use. Stage number three, we have a new model. We converted it to IR, but can it really classify the new classes? Let's run the classification sample. Pick a random rose image, use the new model, and see the results. And with 99.5%, this is a rose. If you check the original model, you'll get zero. I'm trying one example, but you can run the validation app on the full dataset to make sure it's working. Well, it does. Check out video number 33 for the validation app instructions. Now we are at stage number four. Let's run the calibration tool. Dash T, C, the type is classification, dash D, CPU, running on CPU. My input dataset is a flowers photo, and my model is the FP32 IR file. I'm asking for a threshold of 5%, meaning I can suffer degradation of 5% in the accuracy. The first stage will be to run with the FP32 model. There, you can see that my reference accuracy is 85.9%. I allow the tool to go all the way down to 81%, 5% degradation. The tool is running, it takes time, and you can see the accuracy degradation of each iteration. And it reports which layers will be converted to INT8 and a new IR files were generated. Stage number five, you can see the new IR files that were generated by the calibration tool. They are called _i8. Let's try to run again the classification sample with the new calibrated IR. And yes, it's a rose. And like before, you can use a validation utility to verify on the full data set and even debug which images are not classified and why. But we care about performance, so let's run the benchmark up. First, let's run with the original FP32 model, and I'm getting 825 frames per second. INT8 is supported on specific machines only. I'm checking if my machine is supported, LS CPU, and I'm looking for AVX, and my machine supports AVX2, so I can expect some performance boost. Let's run the new calibrated INT8 model, and I'm up from 800 to almost 1000 frames per second. Not bad. If you have a machine that supports AVX 512, you can expect higher performance boost. If you have a cascade-laden machine that supports VNNI, you will get even more. So we demonstrated the full flow of downloading a public classification model, retrain it to classify new classes, generate IR files using the model optimizer, calibrate the IR files using the calibration tool to INT8 format, and run the benchmark utility to check the performance. Please use the official documentation and the forums to ask questions and share feedback. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more videos like this one. Thank you.